should have, like, done my hair.
Hmm. I feel like you can never see how frizzy my hair is. Oh. Until I turn all these lights on, and then it's like...
Hello, and welcome back to my channel. All
right, so before we jump in and start talking, obviously... something is different. I have different teeth and I'm a little lispy. So let's just get that out of the way before I go through the whole video worrying about if I'm lispy or not, because I am a little, I'm a little lispy. I'm not gonna lie. I'm gonna take you back to the beginning. What's going on? What's happening? But we're gonna talk about it all while we put some makeup on our face. I'm just gonna try out some new products that I've been wanting to play with because I actually haven't worn makeup in I don't even know how long it's been since I've worn makeup. So, I'm gonna prep the skin first. Let's get these bangs tucked out. This is my favorite. Meow. Meow. Should I try to roll this up into a bun or something so it's not like... Okay. It's not looking as crazy. Oh, is it though? Oh, oh, oh. So yeah, where the fuck have I been? So between January 6th and like February 8th, within like that 30-day period, we took 13 flights and it really kicked my ass. Like it was intense. Usually anytime I fly, I get sick, and I was down for like 2 weeks. I just think my body was like super exhausted. And even the last time we went back to LA to get our teeth done, I was sick and then I had to fly on top of it. So it was just no bueno. But usually when I do like a lot of traveling, my skin really takes a beating from just like being in the dry air. And I feel like I kind of neglect my skincare when I am traveling because I always bring a carry-on suitcase and I can't be bringing all my skincare products with me. So the majority of the time, I really feel like I just neglect my skin when I'm traveling, which is really bad. But because of the Summer Fridays jet lag mask, I feel like my skin really held it together. So if you guys have not heard about this mask, it is amazing. If you travel a lot, if you just have dry skin in general, this has really been saving my life. I basically use it every single day now, and I also use it to prep my face for my makeup. So I'm just gonna put a little bit of this guy on. I always use way less if I'm using it to prep underneath the skin because you don't want your makeup to like slip and slide all over the place. But I love this because you can put it under your eyes, you can put it over your eyes, you can use it as a overnight mask, which I do almost every single night as well. You can layer it on really thick under your eyes. In my one video, I was talking about I don't really use an eye cream. It's because I just tend to put the Summer Fridays mask underneath my eyes as well. I like it for underneath the makeup because it just creates like a sticky base. So these are just my temporary veneers. It's basically like having two dentures in because it's just one big piece. There's like a big piece on top and then a big piece on bottom. So I honestly can't wait to get the permanents put in. Whew. It was a day, y'all, to get these things in. All right, so this has sunk in. So like I said, I like this. So I like the Summer Fridays. Hopefully when I get my permanents, I won't be as lispy as I am with these. I was really lispy like the first week or so because obviously these teeth are bigger than my teeth. I had the world's smallest, babyest teeth ever. And I never even had like these teeth, like canines. I never had those because I just, I think, grinded them down. Your mouth can detect any kind of small change in your mouth. And my tongue has to get used to hitting my teeth a different way or something. I can't remember what he said, but it's just like, cause your tongue is a muscle, so it has muscle memory of how you speak. So it just has to like relearn how to say words. So hopefully my lip goes away. But these are also thicker than like the actual porcelain veneers will be. So like I said, this, it's basically like two dentures. I have them, they're like, it's just one big piece on the top and on the bottom. So you can't really floss or anything like that. So we have to do coconut oil a lot. We obviously still brush our teeth, but we have to do coconut oil a lot. And I already chipped this guy the first day I had them. I don't even know what I did. And I feel like I've stained them a little bit because I drink coffee. And these are acrylic. And I'm not really pressed about these teeth. I just want my permanents in. So yeah, Beeb's got his teeth done too. And when I tell you he looks like a different human, it's insane. You can just see his teeth so much more because not only did I have small teeth, I have a really small mouth. So like when people see me, they're like, oh, it's like not that big of a difference. And when they see him, they're like, oh. It's a big difference. Like my mom's like, Jeremy's teeth are so great. I'm like, what about mine? What about mine? For foundation today, I'm gonna try the Hourglass Vanish Seamless Foundation. This is in the shade Warm Beige. This might be a little warm for your girl right now because I'm a little on the lighter side, but we're gonna give it a go, see what we got, see what we got. So I'm gonna pump some of this onto my skin. I feel like this might be too dark for me. Oh yeah, like, oh, oh no, we're not putting this on. I'm gonna try Nude instead. But I'm gonna try this little brush that it came, oh my God. What color is this? Yellow? All right, let's work this product. That is really full coverage. Or maybe I just needed one dot. I'm wearing a top. Even if it's my right shade of foundation, I always put foundation like wherever skin is showing because then everything is like the same texture. Do you ever watch like reality TV? Or I don't know, maybe this is just me, but like people will be in interviews and you can tell that they like stop the makeup here because it's just like a different texture. Like all this looks so smooth and airbrushed and then it's like skin. So like if your skin is showing, throw some makeup on it. Doesn't strictly have to be for your face only. So, oh, hi, sir. Blue actually had to go to the vet today because she had like a growth in her ear, which has just been getting like bigger and bigger and bigger. It wasn't like cancer or anything like that. It was just like a growth. The vet said it was just maybe from old age. We didn't even notice it for the longest time, but it's like right where she would scratch her ear. So she had to go get it removed today. The vet just texted me and said she was done and she did good and... Can you not knock mom's stuff over, please? And that she did good and we could pick her up after 2 o'clock. It's only like 9 in the morning right now. I'm just kind of disappointed that it wasn't like my actual shade. Because when things aren't your actual shade, you just have to work a lot harder. Sir! This is not my shade. Like, look at my arm. I gotta be careful with my ears. My ears are still going through it. I gotta... What are those things called? Keloids from piercings? I got one on my conch, so I've been trying to handle that guy, which sucks because I feel like I take such good care of them. I'm still sleeping on a neck pillow, but I got one anyway. It's a little on the matte side for my liking. I like a foundation that has a little bit more luminosity to it. My mom's calling me, guys. Hold, please. Hello. Also, if you have ear piercings, these things will save your damn life because even still now, like when I talk on the phone, it hurts. Juice is right here. Hey, ow, look at those feet. Look up, can mom clean your eyes? We literally have to clean his eyes when he's asleep, otherwise he'll try to fight us. And do you see the size of these paws? So, remember when I said I was gonna get my eyebrows done? I lied to you.
What?
Okay, I didn't get them done. Sir, we're still going. We're still going strong. But it doesn't even bother me anymore. It's wild. So I have been using this Benefit Precisely My Brow Pencil, and it's in the shade 4 to just kind of fill in what we've got going on here. What do I really think about this foundation? I feel like it's settling on my nose. I don't know if I love it. See, like, all that brow hair underneath, it could go. Like, I don't need it, but I'm, like, attached to it. Like, I grew it, and it's mine, and I, like, I don't want to get rid of it. But I know that I need to. So, the reason that I got my teeth done is I've always had issues with my teeth. I've had so many root canals. if you didn't know, like, teeth are pretty hereditary, and my grandma lost all of her teeth. When my mom got pregnant, her teeth became really weak, and she lost all of her teeth. So, she actually has dental implants because she just had very weak enamel, which is what I had as well. So, my front tooth was, like, super short, and it was, like, an S on the bottom. And I would always like chip my teeth. My teeth in the back were like so chipped. It was crazy. Like I would always have difficulty eating because I could only chew on like one side of my mouth. And I just always had issues with my teeth. And I've known that I've wanted to get veneers for a really long time. And the thing that just kind of pushed me overboard to get the veneers is I had always had gaps in my teeth. Those were just my teeth. I never had braces or anything like that. But I always had gaps in my teeth starting from like here and going like all the way around. And I had a gap in the middle of my tooth for a long time. It just wasn't as noticeable as it has been. And I feel like it was just like over time, my teeth were just kind of shifting and separating a little more. And I was like, is this gap just gonna grow on forever? Because some days I would look at myself in the mirror and I'm like, I could fit like a freaking french fry in between it sometimes. It just seems so intense. So that was kind of like the tipping point for me being like, all right, let me get some damn veneers because I'm tired of my baby ass teeth, first of all. They were so tiny. And I just knew the gaps were gonna get progressively larger because that's just what it was leading up to. And also the color of my teeth, I was never satisfied with. And because I had such weak enamel, I could never whiten them because it wouldn't do anything. It would just make my teeth sensitive. And I was like, you know what, let me just get some damn veneers. So I thought it was gonna be like easy and, you know, I don't know. I just thought it was gonna be easy. Girl, it was not easy, okay? It was like 5 hours. I had a panic attack mid drilling and I don't even know why. Like, the dentist doesn't really scare me. I don't like going to the dentist. Obviously, who wants people's hands all in your mouth and shit? But I've never been scared of the dentist and I've gotten 5 root canals. I can deal with the drilling. I don't know what happened. I was fine and then I was not fine. I don't think I've ever had a panic attack before, but I got really lightheaded, nauseous. I was just crying out of nowhere. My whole body was just like super tense. Thank God Biebs was there because he came into the room because he had already gotten his teeth done by then. And he came in the room and just, we were doing like breathing exercises, you know, in for 4, hold for 4, out for 4. And that really helped calm me down. But it was like a good 30, 40 minutes of me just in freak out panic mode. And I, like I said, I don't even know what happened. I was fine and then I wasn't fine. Is this foundation giving me an allergic reaction? Like, what's going on my neck? So I'm gonna use this full spectrum palette from Covergirl. This is called Reverence. I'm gonna grab this first shade here and we're gonna use this underneath our brow. And if you can see like a little like shadow right there, that is my tooth underneath. he said you could just kind of see it through the acrylic teeth, but obviously when I get my perms, that guy won't be there. You can see it on Biebs too, which is annoying. So I'm gonna pick up this brown here in the palette and I love this brush. This is from Zoeva and this is a luxe crease brush. It's one of my favorites. I have a smaller version of this too, which is amazing. And I'm gonna start here in the corner and just kind of work it out. Work it out, work it out. I like taking it like right up into my brow hair there. And we're gonna keep it like kind of close. Very round shape. I really like these CoverGirl palettes. I think they're very pigmented and easy to blend shadows. I was gonna use the new Naked palette for this look, but I feel like I liked the shades better in this palette. I'm kind of blending this onto the lid as well because, like I said, I just wanna do like a soft brown eye today. Like all brown. Our lip's gonna be brown, I think. This is just the one shade. I really like to do looks that just mainly involve 2 eyeshadows. Not like 3,000, but those are cute too. Y'all, I'm not into this foundation. Like, I'm not into it. So I'm gonna take off this foundation. And I don't know if you guys can see my neck area, but like, what is happening? And it's making me nervous about my face. So, and there's like no found, It looks way worse in person than it does on camera because the lights are so bright. It's kind of like dulling it out. So I'm gonna go in with this Maybelline Superstay Multi-Use Foundation Stick. This is in the shade 125. And we're just gonna go from there. This is one of my favorite drugstore stick foundations as well. And I'm liking this color a lot better. Like, I'm not so yellow. I was trying to make that work. But when I can see the foundation hanging out on my skin, like, I don't like that at all. Like, look at that color. We're gonna blend, don't worry. Since it's been sitting here for a while, I'm just gonna spray it down with some setting spray.
I wonder if it was the brush or the actual makeup itself. I hope it's just the brush and my skin is just extra sensitive, which I know. Okay, this is looking better.
And I don't think that I have to tell you guys, but I'm gonna tell you anyway, we're using light brusher. I always thought that I had like acne prone skin because I was oily, but ever since I started getting facials, she is like, no, you have really sensitive skin. I'm like, oh damn, all this time I thought I didn't have sensitive skin and then would wonder why I broke out from trying new things. So I'm gonna throw a couple of coats of mascara on before we put on our false lashes. And I just wanted to quickly mention this. This is from Essence and this is the Lash Princess Sculpted Volume Mascara. I don't know what, I've tried a bunch of their mascaras and they're all really good. I love all the brushes, but this one is magical. I really like the brush on it too because it has a little curve and it just makes your lashes look so long. Hi. So I'm gonna go with the bottom set because it's a little more tapered in the front, not as long as this guy is up top. So we're gonna do this bottom set. So always give your lash glue a second to get tacky. I feel like that's the tip everyone gets, but it's super true. It's just going to actually stick onto your eye when you place it on there, and it's not going to move all over the place. So I always like to anchor down the center first, like right where it's gonna be, and then you can kind of adjust. So this guy needs to be pulled over more, I can tell. And then I always put the end on last. See how he just kind of stuck right on there without it sliding all over the place? But you can still maneuver it. It's still wet enough that you can move your lash around if you need to. It's just gonna be easier for you. And then I just start pushing the lash down onto my lash line and then clamp everything down together. And then I always push my lash upwards, especially at the end, because we've had this discussion, right? Where you don't want the end of your lash to be pointing downward because it's going to give your eye a droopy appearance. So I always just push up on the lashes. You could curl them, obviously, but sometimes you can catch your lash, the glue, and pull your whole lash off. So I just always use my finger and just let it sit there for a second. This way your lashes are up as they should be and not like pointing straight down like that. Juice. Really? Water plumping primer from Stila. Let's throw a little bit of this on. Oh. What if this was like my actual lip color that I was gonna go with for the day? I don't know what this is, but I just saw it sitting there. And it is a Lush Lips Water Plumping Primer. I don't know how far in advance that you're supposed to put this on. Big boy juicy, big boy juicy. Does mom smell different with foundation on?
So for concealer, I'm gonna try this MAC Studio Fix 24 Hour Smooth Wear Concealer. Oh, okay. That's a little light. Look how much darker it looks in the tube.
Y'all are deceiving.
And I'm gonna take this guy from BH. And this is really light. Take our beauty blender, which always saves the day. Pick this up. I haven't been this bright under the eye in a minute. But I'm actually not mad at it. I'm gonna add a little to the chin just so it kind of pulls it all together so it's not like the under eyes are like, hi. But I actually don't mind it once it's like fully blended out. To set my under eyes, I'm gonna use the Ben Nye Fair Translucent Powder and I'm just gonna put a little bit of this in my hand. Tap, tap, tap. And then set. Pretty. And then I'm gonna do a little bit of baking because I just need this makeup to last all day and it's pretty early in the day. So again, I'm just gonna add some of this to my hand and pick up on my beauty blender and then just bake this under the eye. And then to set the rest of my face, because I really want to lock everything in, I'm going to use this Kat Von D Lock It powder foundation, which is really amazing. I use this on days when I don't want to do like a lot of makeup. I'm really into the Bare Minerals as well. And I'm just going to take it on the brush and then push this into the skin.
Am I getting makeup on you? I'm sorry. I'm sorry, bud.
All right, so for bronzer, I'm still using this Victoria Beckham Estee Lauder one. I feel like I don't know like a really good bronzer anymore, so I just kind of stick with this guy. I always like to do a lot on the temples because I just feel like it like brings your face in. For blush, we're gonna use this Jouer blush palette, and we're gonna pick up a little bit of Adore Me. Blush is like one of my favorite things. Then I'm gonna take the KKW, what is this? This is the brightening powder in shade 2. Favorite, 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 must have. I feel lost without this. I'm gonna pop this underneath my eye. I feel like it really makes everything super smooth. And then I always bring it down onto my cheek for like a really seamless blend. Okay, now we're gonna spray the shit out of our face. I'm gonna use the Urban Decay All Nighter Spray, and you're really gonna go ham when you spray your face, just because we put so much powder on. So do not be stingy with your setting spray. Juicy, you might not like this part. Don't be stingy. Then I just take my beauty blender and just kind of tap over my whole face. Oh shit, there's powder on it. So you guys already know what I'm putting in my waterline, right? This is a Makeup Forever Artist color pencil. You can use these on your lids, you can use these under your eyes, your waterline, lip liner, you can use these anywhere on your face. This is just like my go-to for my waterline. I like how like red and warm it is in my waterline, but it's like not like that underneath. Take that same brown shade that we were using in our Covergirl palette, and then just kind of smudge this underneath our lower lash line. For my lower lash line, I'm gonna go in with the Jennifer Lopez Inglot Mascara. This I really only use on my lower lash line because the brush is so small. And I'm just gonna run some quickly up top. You can use any mascara for this. I like to get like the tips of the lash. For our lips, we're gonna do a dark liner. This is Chestnut from MAC. I don't so much over-align my lower lip as I cast like a shadow underneath it, just to make it look more plump. I'm gonna take Double Shot, which is like a brownie shade as well, just a little lighter. And then I'm just gonna pick up some of this clear gloss from Shiseido and just kind of tap it on. Pull these hairs over the ears to hide what's going on back there. So I hope you guys enjoyed this look. If you've never tried a brown lip, I definitely recommend it. It's like a lip that, I don't know, it makes you feel some type of way when you put it on. So again, I hope you guys enjoyed. As always, everything will be listed in the bottom bar. In case I didn't mention what I was using, it will be listed down below. I hope you enjoyed hanging out with me because I enjoyed sitting here talking to you. And hopefully my lisp goes away soon. So I love you guys, and I will see you super soon in another video. Bye.